I am Samitinji Kasinsode from JSPM and ASSM Group of Institute, Narendra. I welcome you in the Laboratory of Transportation Engineering. Today we are going to see the experiment. This experiment is based on the mixed design of the bitumen with the aggregate. So here what happens, so while designing the flexural pavements, at that time we have to think about at what percentage we have to add the bitumen, or what will be the mix of the different aggregates. So while preparing any kind of the flexural pavement thickness or layer, so in that layer what we have to do, we have to define that layer first. It will be the DPM or SDBC or just BC. So depending on that, we have to decide the type of aggregate what should be used and how much the quantity of the bitumen should be used. So here we are going to use minimum 3 to 4 different types of the aggregates, inside which also we are going to add the filler material, and we are also going to add the lime inside it for just binding together. So here how much percentage of bitumen that will be calculated depending on the moisture stability. So this experiment is based on the stability machine. So this machine is manufactured or just they have been invented by the Marshall, it was the scientist. So the name is given to the Marshall stability. So here we can see the pedestrian. Here we can see the pedestrian, and this pedestrian is used to just have the sample inside it. So this is the sample in which we are going to just place the sample. We are going to put inside this is the special hammer which has been manufactured for the gloves for the Marshall stability. So here the weight of the sample is 10 kg, so we have to just place this hand. After that we have to just lift this hand to the sample here. So this is called as the pedestrian, and this is the hammer which is used for the Marshall stability. Now coming towards the assembly which you are using here, so this is called as the breaking head. This whole assembly is called as the breaking head. It having two halves. This is the above and below part is there. In the above part we have attached the probing ring, so on the probing ring we can get the load reading. So here we are getting the loading. So this probing ring is for the 30 kN which has been used here, and this another dial gauge is there. On this dial gauge we are just finding out what is the flow value of this sample. So what happens, this load it has been applied downwards, so we have to just calculate how much the gap is there. So what happens, due to the application of load, the this gap it is being closer to that, so we have to find out what how much that gap is, and for that gap how much is the maximum load. So after failure of the sample what happens, this will be attained at the maximum load, and at that maximum load what is the maximum flow value that we have to calculate. So maximum flow value that will be getting from this dial gauge, and a load that we'll get from this dial gauge. So this is the whole assembly. This is the Marshall stability machine or apparatus we call it as. So here we can load, unload and load same thing. So loading that will be used while placing the sample inside it, and while withdrawing sample from the machine, and we can apply the load to moving just this downward direction. And if we don't have the, like it can be also operated on the without electricity, so we can operate it with the help of this wheel. So load that will be applied from this wheel also. So this is about the machine and pedestrian that we are going to use for the finding out the Marshall stability, or the maximum load that can be taken by the sample, and the flow value that can be taken by the sample. Now we are going to design the dense bituminous macadam. So this is the one layer that will be used for the different flexural pavement. So this DBM, what are the requirement that we will see first. So minimum stability is 9 kN for the VG, that viscosity grade paving bitumen, and 12 kiloNewton for the modified bitumen. So modified bitumens means what if you are adding some ingredient in the bitumen, natural bitumen, that will be called as the modified bitumen. Then minimum flow value requirement, that it should be in between 2 to 4 mm only. So Marshall quotient, it will be in between 2 to 5 kiloNewton per millimeter. So here we are going to use the two types of the grade. So grade one, that will be used for the 40 mm size of aggregate. So for that 40 mm size of aggregate, we have to find out, or we have to use the 4% bitumen. And for grade two, for the 20 mm size of aggregate or minimum on that, we are going to use the 4.5% of the bitumen of their original weight. So in both the grade, we are going to use the filler of 2% for the of the weight of the aggregate. Then stripping value, it should not be more than 5%. It means that 95% aggregate, that should not be stripped. Okay, so this is the again one requirement of that. Then percentage of air voids, that should be in between 3 to 5%. So again, if you observe the physical properties of the aggregate, so we have to do the sieve analysis as per 2386 for defining whether it is for the grade 1 or grade 2. Then we have to identify the physical properties, that loss endurance abrasion, impact value, flakiness and elongation index, that should be within the specified limit by the IRC, Indian Road Congress. Okay, so stripping value of aggregate, maximum retained coating is 95%, that is, it means that 5% that can be possible. Then water absorption, it is the maximum of the 2%, and specific gravity, that should be determined properly. And also we have to find out the plasticity index. This will be used for the crushed sand. Okay, sometimes what happens that if someone is using the river sand, in that case we have to find out whether the plasticity is present in that or not. So we have to go for the testing of bitumen also. So we have to find out the softening point. It should be minimum 47 degrees centigrade. Then penetration value, it should be in between 50 to 70 mm. Then the specific gravity, it should be present in between 0.98 to 1.2. Flash point is minimum about 220 degrees centigrade, and ductility value, that will be the minimum 40 mm. So this is about the testing of the bitumen. After then, we have to find out the combined blend of the sieve analysis. What happens if you are going to choose the grade 2 aggregate? So grade 2 aggregate, that will compare, means 25 mm, 20 mm, 12.5 mm, like that. So 100% plasticity, 80% plasticity, 98% plasticity, that should be taken with the combined blend of this sieve analysis. And after then, we are going to do the Marshall test. So for doing the Marshall test, what we have to do, we have to take the Marshall Marshall cup. So in that we have to take around 1200 gram of aggregate for that purpose. So here what we are doing, we are adding 20 mm size of aggregate, then 10 mm, then 6 mm and crushed sand, and lastly we are going to add the filler, that is the stone dust. So here this will be taken depending on the trial and error base. So here I am going to take 42% of the 20 mm aggregate, then 8% of the 10 mm aggregate, then 8% of the again 6 mm aggregate, and crushed sand is about 40%, and lastly filler is about the 2%. So here if you observe the percentage of this aggregate, so here 40 8 8 40, then again 2%. So this little aggregate, little size aggregate, that will be added inside. That means if you are using the coarser aggregate, so a smaller aggregate, that will be fitted in between that, and the gap, it has been filled. So again we are going to pouring bitumen inside that, so that will be just completely impermeable structure that will be formed. But it will be act as a flexible when we are going to add some different aggregate size to aggregate. So it will be, just if you observe by the binocular, we can observe that it is taking a breathing while load is there. If you are passing some trailer or tractor on this, so we can found that the road is becoming like this, and after removing of the load, so our road, that will be get its original shape. So for just taking the 1200 gram sample for preparing one sample, so I am going to use a 504 gram of the 20 mm, then 96 mm of the 10 mm size, then 96 gram of the 6 mm aggregate and 480 gram of the crush sand and 24 gram of the filler sand. Okay, that this should be prepared in sample, and with the help of just 3 to 5% of the bitumen, means 4.5, we are going to take as the 4.5% as the bitumen content. Okay, so that much bitumen content it will be the added with this 1200 gram weight. So that much addition of the bitumen will be there. So before that, what we have to do, we have to heat the aggregate. Means aggregate that will be heated, we are going to give the delta to the aggregate also. It will be heated around 150 to 160 degrees centigrade, and then we are going to also heat the bitumen. Bitumen also heated at the 155 to 165 degrees centigrade. So here if you found that the temperature, some very little temperature variation is there in between the aggregate and the bitumen. So after that, we have to just keep in mind that mixing temperature should be present in between 145 to 160 degrees centigrade. So here we have to just mix it with the heating so that it will be prepared properly. Again, after placing the mould, we have to apply the 25 blows. But while applying 25 blows, we are giving the compaction at that time, we should also take the temperature of this sample also. Then we have to apply the 75 blows on the either sides of the sample, so that it will give the fully compacted, and we have to keep it up for the 24 hours at the room temperature for the sample. After then, we are going to taking the number of times, we are just taking the masses of that sample. So just dry weight of that sample, then again we are going to take the saturated weight. For taking the saturated, what we have to do, we have to keep that mould in our water bath at 60 degree temperature for the 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes we are going to take the weight of that, and this weight it will be called as the saturated weight of the aggregate. Then we are going to place this mould in the baking mould. And we are going to just find out the deflection. So here deflection is called as the flow, and load that will be calculated from the machine. So at maximum load, how much flow is there, that should be found out by using the Marshall stability machine. So we will do the experiment now. I have prepared this mold, and with the help of all this procedure what I have just told, this procedure I have adopted for processing the mold. And that mold it has been placed in the breaking head. Now we are going to do the practical. I already explained what is the breaking head. So this is called as the breaking head, and dial gauges it has been also placed in the position. We can observe the zero reading on the both dial gauges. So I can adjust this dial gauge with the help of this screw. Okay. So this is also zero, and that is also zero. Now we need two peoples, because both the dial gauges that should be recorded. So we are going to record both the dial gauges, and we are going to find out the load versus load and the deflection. So just I will start the machine. The load is applied here. So it has been reversed at the position. So we can say that the failure of that machine is at observe that this mould while loading it was taking the clockwise direction. Now unloading at that time it will be at the reverse. So the maximum load that we have to observe continuously on this, and what the maximum load is, that maximum load that should be taken for the calculation purpose, and the value which we got here, the flow value, that should be also recorded. So we have to do this experiment for both all the three samples, and just I have recorded all the readings. So we will just find out how the Marshall stability, that value of the sample that will be calculated. Okay, after doing the experiment, We have did that experiment for the three different samples, sample 1, sample 2, sample 3. We have taken the bitumen content at the 4.5% while addition. So we have recorded the some readings from the samples. So here records are weight of the core in air. So it was the 1275 grams for the sample 1. Then weight of the core in water, it is the 765 grams. Then saturated surface dry core weight that we have found, that is 1285 grams. Volume of core, so for finding out the volume of core, what we have to do, we have to just do the 3 minus 2, we will get the volume of core. It is about 520 centimeter cubes. Then density of the cube, that is 1 divided for 4 means weight of the core in air divided by the volume, so we will get the density of that core. So for the Marshall stability, we have taken this load from the Marshall stability machine. So the load was 14.3 kilonewton and the flow value, it is about 3.219 millimeter. So Marshall quotient is nothing but the 6 divided by 7, that is 4.30 divided by the 3. So the value is coming about 4.44. And we have also done the bitumen content for this test. So bitumen content, it was found that the 5.19%. So again, we have to do for the 1270 means sample 2, weight of, weight of the sample in air, then in water, then surface saturated dry core weight, then we have found out the volume, then density of the core. This is the Marshall stability load that is taken by the sample. It was the 9.310 kilonewton. This is the flow value or deflection, it is the 3.102 millimeter. Marshall quotient is the 3, and the bitumen content was found that 4.68%, and last sample it was the 1270. So likewise, here we have get the result that Marshall stability for this is around 12.12, and here flow value is 3.187. So what we have to do, we have to just take all the samples, all the criteria with us, that this criteria is minimum stability is 9 kilonewton. So all these three samples having the 9 kilonewton. So it means that Marshall stability criteria that has been followed by the all these samples. Then three flow value we have to take into consideration, 3.219, 3.102, this is the 3.187. So here Marshall stability is load is also maximum, that is the 14.30 kilonewton, and flow value is around 3.219 millimeter. So after then what we have to do, we have to plot the graphs. So these graphs that will be in between percentage of bitumen versus the stability, then percentage of bitumen versus the flow value, then percentage of bitumen versus the unit weights, then percentage of bitumen versus the VFB, and the percentage of bitumen versus the air voids. So here what we have to do, we have to choose the optimum values of this, you know. So after checking the optimum values, we have to just find out what is the percentage of bitumen that is recorded for that. So we will find out that percentage of bitumen, and this percentage of bitumen that will be suggested for the mix. So what happens while choosing the different types of the aggregate? So on this sheet we have chosen that 20 mm aggregate to 42%, 10 mm aggregate 0.8%, 6 mm 8%, crust sand 40%, and filler sand that will be the 2%. So here it may be happen that we have to change this percentage of all aggregates, and also there may be chance that we have to take the bitumen content that will be more than the 4.5%. So taking into consideration all these things on this Marshall stability, we have to find out such value that which will give us the maximum Marshall stability and minimum deflection. Sorry, that will have the deflection, it will be the region within the range, that will be the 2 to 4 mm. This 2 to 4 mm value that will be taken into consideration for the all kind of the Marshall stability checking. So here we can say that the Marshall stability of sample number 1, which we have taken into consideration, that will be good for the checking. So here we have found out that bitumen content is 5.19%. In this category, so we can suggest that we have to choose the aggregate 20 mm, 42, 10 mm, 8%, 6 mm, 8%, crush sand 40%, and the filler will be the 2%, and bitumen content is the 5.19%. So this will be the our final conclusion by studying the graphs and by doing the experiment. So thank you.